a good Samaritan just called in and an owl hit their house and won't get up. The people were very unclear if the wing is hurt, you know, if we've got other internal injuries. I don't really know what I'm running into, but anytime we can help wildlife, I think that's good. These animals don't have anybody looking out for them.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm good. It's okay, baby. It's okay.
Oh, yeah. My goodness.
Won't let go of my gloves.
Beautiful animal.
I know.
This is an eastern screech owl. These guys are very, very common in Nebraska. They're just part of the landscape here. Where did you find the little owl?
Just right.
Right there.
Right there.
It was sitting there, unable to move?
Yeah. Looked like there was a little bit of blood, so I don't know if it hit his head and has some head trauma.
I see one eye is not opening.
Now, when I came out, she had just the one eye open. She had started to open the other eye better for me for a while. Mm-hmm. The first time she didn't take water, the second time she did.
Yeah.
Maybe she's going.
I hope not. She's still breathing pretty nicely here for us. I've probably treated 15 to 20 owls in my career. I've been practicing for about that long. So that's about once a year, just like Christmas. I'm really excited about this.
Do you want to cover her up
again? Yeah, let's put her right back in there and keep the wind and light out of her eyes.
Grabbed a shoebox. It was all I had.
It's perfect. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank
you. Bye-bye.
I'll be sure to return your gloves. Sit tight. I remember being a little kid, and I saw an owl in our barn. And I was kind of freaked out. He got some big old talons. He can turn his head almost all the way around. But in vet school, after I got to treat a few of these guys, it's like, these guys are awesome. Hey, little baby.
Hey, honey.
Hi, hon.
What'd you find?
This is the little screech owl.
Okay.
There's definitely an injury here. You can see all that bruising around the eye.
Some sort of impact trauma here.
The pupil.
Is light responsive?
Yeah, you want to grab our ophthalmoscope? What we're testing right now is his PLR, or his pupillary light reflex. We're using a very strong light to see if his pupil constricts, and that will tell us if his iris is intact or if it's injured.
Yes, yep, there it was.
And good. Here's his right.
Pretty good?
Really good.
Mm-hmm.
Yep, they're both good.
Okay.
We definitely have some neurologic issues, though.
Yeah, there's definitely a head tilt.
Mm-hmm.
We are going to take an x-ray of him, see if he has any fractures, so we can make sure that there's nothing else wrong with him.
So the wings look good.
His long bones look fine.
I really don't see a cranium fracture at all. Well, hopefully this is just a knock to the head.
It looks like there's nothing really wrong internally, but we just can't treat him and set him free. We have to make sure he's okay. You know, he's wildlife, and they are more touch and go than a domestic species. There's a lot of blood in the back of the eye.
Yeah.
So I'm really concerned about a detached retina.
Okay.
So we're probably gonna need to start looking into a sanctuary. We have a place that we can send these little owls. We can get treatments and start using that eye again and see if he's able to go back into the wild someday. If that's gonna happen, we need to give him all the care we can to make a smooth transition.
So what's our treatment plan?
Pain medication, probably twice a day, because I really think we need it.
Yep.
Some sub-Q fluids, you know, just to rehydrate here because of all this stress today. And then to feed this little owl, let's go with some really mashed up watery kitty food.
I love that plan. I think that kind of ticks all the boxes.
I really do wish this little guy could talk to me and just tell me exactly what's wrong with him. That's the curse of our job, is they can't ever tell us exactly where it hurts.
What a cutie. I mean, this is about the softest animal I think I've ever pet.
It's gonna be green soon. I had my sunglasses on here the other day and everything looked green and it was beautiful.
It's working on getting warm.
Woo! So we are headed to the Loop Farm. They have a slew of kitties. I've kind of lost count. Oh, I see one escapee already. The Loops have us come out every year to vaccinate all of their kitties. We have to keep them all healthy because they have an important role on the farm as rodent catchers.
How many cats do you have for us today?
We have 20 total.
All right, let's go wrangle those.
All right.
I got one.
You got one, good, good job.
Come here, kitty, kitty.
Ben and Aaron look after our cats, and then they also help take care of our cow-calf operation.
I think he's afraid of big yellow boots. It's okay.
Because of all the livestock that the Lutes have, there's lots of grain and feed that mice like to get into.
Got him? Good job, Mark.
And where they eat, they go potty, and that can cause some problems and some diseases in the animals. So these cats have a lot to do.
Gotcha. Hi.
Hey, buddy.
Good job, guys.
Oh, hi, kitties.
Hi. Oh, my goodness.
This is like the mother load of cat Christmas.
Because the Lutes have such a large cat population, it's a lot easier for us and the kitties to just take care of them at their home place. So we will move them through like an assembly line.
Let's get a quick weight on this one.
We weigh them, check their ears, their eyes, their teeth, overall body condition, and then we give them their vaccines and we deworm them.
I wonder if part of the reason she's a little more grumpy is because she has a little ear debris.
We really, really want to look for anything that might be catching. If one of these kitties has this, the likelihood that we're going to see this in multiple cats is really high.
Ooh, look at those ears. See all that debris in there? Oh, I know. Oh, and see how
really
itchy.
Itches.
Says, ouch,
oh,
ouch,
it's
ouch.
Okay.
And so this is what I'm getting out. It's tough to tell what we have without really checking it under the microscope. So I'll put this with his file. All right, okay. Snowball.
Snowflake.
Snowflake.
Oh, careful.
In you go.
There you go.
Put the pills in and the worms come out. Yeah, good kitty.
Go.
So what's this one's name?
White Nose.
White Nose.
Oh, he loves you.
Yes, hi. You can come home with me. Oh my goodness, here we go.
Very good.
See, that's itchy. So we might have multiple things going on in these kitties. Mites are contagious, so if we find some, we'll give you a call.
Okay.
You guys have amazing cats. If I were gonna die and come back as a cat, I'd come to your farm.
Thank you, I appreciate that.
Could you imagine how awesome having 20 cats would be?
Don't be getting any ideas.
I'm in the clinic today taking care of all the in-house patients, and Ben is out on the road doing all the farm calls.
We're going to process a little over 300 900-pound steers today. Vaccinating, deworming. If they need some antibiotics, we're going to be able to give it to them today. Jeff, you close the gate so nothing gets out. You ready to go?
We'll get done.
Okay, let's go get them. First thing we need to do is move these cattle into the corral. Then we'll move them one by one into the chute for treatment. So this is the dewormer. Hopefully help them gain a little more weight, get rid of all their parasites internally. Caitlin's given the vaccines. Carly's putting on the pour on for the lice. Got a pretty good team here today. Some of them were sick with respiratory problems, some pneumonia. Some of them had some bad eyes.
Looks like some pink eye.
He definitely deserves a shot of antibiotics so we can get this healed up. A lot of them had ringworm. With all the wet weather we've been having, a lot of these cattle have been having some fungus grow around their face and their eyes. It's something just to know, it will get better with some sunshine. There's an old saying in the cattle industry, sunshine cures a lot of evils. All right, guys, good job. I'm a big guy, but these animals are 5 to 6 times my weight. That was a big day. I love working outside, but it's exhausting. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you.
It's always good seeing you.
Cedar County Vet in Huntington, this is Caitlin.
Never happens. He's just not a napper. So I gotta have a little fun with this. He must have just really been exhausted. So I kind of feel bad that I have to go wake him up, but the day must go on.
Time for you to go to work. You okay? Yeah.
Oh my gosh, I'm late.
It's all right.
Fallen asleep in my truck before. Luckily, I was pulled over on the side of the road, but this is the first time I've taken a nap at the clinic.
Val thought you were dead.
No,
she was
no.
Like, what's going on? Like,
did she at least check if I was breathing?
Yeah, we all did.
Okay, good. Yeah. I feel refreshed. Gotta love these early morning calls, don't you?
Sherry is bringing in her mama corgi that had four puppies at 2 o'clock this morning, and she's been pushing 6.5 hours since the last puppy. I'm sure there's more puppies in there. So
yeah.
Told her to grab mama, grab puppies, and head right to the clinic. We gotta hurry up, let's do this, baby.
All right.
Hi, Sandy, you got baby stuck, come on.
I think she does, she's panting.
Oh, she still looks really full.
Obviously, things are not progressing properly.
Oh my goodness, you look like you have a hippopotamus still stuck in there, Sandy.
Anything longer than 4 hours, especially while we have active pushing and nothing's happening, it's not a good situation. We take x-rays and see what the reason is.
Oh, still peeing down me. Woo, lots of pee. Lots and lots of pee.
Honey, I need you to come help me do this x-ray so we can see what we've got inside mama.
All right.
Sherry, we'll show you what we got here. So there's a reason she can't have any more, and she's got a whole boatload of them. See, this one is bent in a U, and it can't come out.
Oh, no.
So she has to have a C-section.
Okay.
Okay.
Are they gonna make it?
This one, I would say, has a very low chance of making it. I think there's probably been so much pressure that it's been too high stress. If we don't do the C-section right away, we could really risk rupturing her uterus, and then we have puppies in her abdomen. Sandy can die from that.
Are they gonna make it?
This one, I would say, has a very low chance of making it. This mother has already given birth to 4 puppies, but she has another 5 stuck inside her. If we don't get these babies out, Sandy can die from that.
I just gotta stay positive, think for the best. They mean a lot to me.
They're here.
Hi, guys.
Right in time.
Our clinic staff is all at home with their families. We need all the help we can get.
Okay, it's taking effect.
It's great that we have Charlie and Chase that can come in. This is not the first time they've had to help.
Pick her up and set her back down. There you go.
Okay, good.
Good, she's got really good anesthetic numbers. Less than 1 for ISO.
Yep, she's really light.
She's really, what mom means by light is she never wants to have them very deep in surgery for a C-section. We don't want the puppies to absorb all that anesthetic, okay? Because that puts them to sleep too. So we have to go fast.
Can you start shaving, honey? Let's go.
Yep. How you coming, Aaron?
We gotta get these puppies out now. We're gonna cut.
Okay, she's in the abdomen. She's looking for the uterus.
Here we go. There's a ton of puppies.
Okay, you ready?
Okay, there's 1.
Okay, just start rubbing.
These puppies did not go through that birth canal. We've got to basically stimulate them. That's going to trigger those instinctual responses. That's going to get them pepped up. We got another one.
Sherry, I need you to run in here and help, please.
We're basically trying to mimic Mother Nature.
Oh yeah, we're active already. We literally are gonna need another person.
Just take it. Mm-hmm. More clamps.
I need more towels off that table in there, please.
Another puppy.
Okay. How many more you got?
I think that's it. Out and out.
Just keep stimulating, Char.
Keep rubbing. Rub harder, boys.
Be kind of aggressive with them and move them around. Yeah, we're rubbing. Oh yeah, we got life here.
Oh yeah.
Is anybody not moving?
Maybe this one.
Keep working.
Is that the one that was stuck?
Yeah, it's a stressed one. The mommy, unfortunately, had been pushing on that puppy, trying to have it for about 6 hours, and it turned it into a U, you know, which basically plugged the hole for the rest of the puppies.
Hon?
Yeah, I'm working on him. Come on. Come on.
If anybody can save a puppy, it's gonna be Ben. He will do whatever it takes.
Come on. Come on.
Can you breathe him?
Charlie, I want you to rub him really nice and hard, just like that, on the chest. I want to make him a little oxygen tent.
Come on, little guy. Let's go.
Come on, baby. Oh, yeah.
Oh, he is.
He was breathing.
Oh.
Come on. Good job. There's another breath. Keep going. Starting to be more regular.
Yay.
It's amazing. We've got a live puppy after all this work. This puppy and I are intimately involved this morning. We already made out a little bit of mouth to mouth, just so you know.
Nope. Listerines. No. You go, yeah. Yeah.
You did good, puppy man.
I know.
I'm proud of you.
We had such a moment earlier. We have to have one more.
This is really gross. Poor cats.
Hey, Val, come here. Coming.
So I'm reviewing the ear mite swabs that we took from the Loot cats, and I found a mite dance party. Look at him. Doesn't that make you just bleh?
Itch?
Yeah. On this slide, we see like papa mites, mama mites, baby mites, mite eggs, so there's still like a whole nother generation to hatch.
Yucks.
Unfortunately, every kitty that we took samples from has the same situation. We need to get them treated stat. So I'm gonna give the Lutes a call and make arrangements for them to pick up this medication.
Hi, this is Cedar County Vet.
How are you?
Good.
The Halutes are coming into the clinic today to pick up their ear mite medicine, and they brought one of the kitties with them.
Hi, guys.
White Nose's ear mite problem has really progressed, and now he has a really swollen ear.
Holy Toledo's, that's a big ear. Yes, you look like you have a grape tomato covered in fur.
He's got a hematoma. He just itched hard enough or shook his head hard enough that a blood vessel in that ear ruptured, and so he's just got a big blood clot in his ear. Okay. If you didn't fix this, we can get an infection in that hematoma, and it's not very comfortable to the kitty. The best thing will be to actually do a little surgery where we open that up, get it all out, and this will be great because we're gonna completely clean out the ear mites.
Okay, okay.
Clean it up.
Good.
Mm-hmm.
Awesome.
Well, will you get to stay with me?
Oh, yeah, okay.
What do you think, handsome?
My white nose.
Okay, well, thank you, guys.
Oh, thank you.
I told the Lutes to treat all of their other kitties with this ear mite medication today. That will hopefully stop the itching, and so White Nose will be the only kitty checking into the Hematoma Hotel. These are one of my least favorite calls.
It's an emergency. We could show up and she could be up, she could be down.
We got a call from Logan and Stacy, and they breed beautiful Charolais cattle on their farm. One of their first time moms just gave birth, and unfortunately the calf did not survive. To make matters worse, the cow has now fully prolapsed her uterus.
50% of the time after I get the phone call, the poor cow has died by the time I get there. I mean, that is how serious this is. Go.
Her entire uterus is turned inside out and is now hanging outside of her body.
Yeah, that's bad.
Uh-oh, she's going down.
Be nice and easy, Aaron. Yeah, there you go, there you go. Here, I'm gonna help keep her down. We're gonna put your towel underneath it.
Yep.
It's full of debris. We gotta get that all clean. Can you bring me the sleeves and the iodine? Thank you. How's she doing, Logan? Okay so far?
Yeah.
Good. We got to get it in. That's the main goal right now.
I gotta be really careful not to use my fingers and put a hole in it. That would be the end of the uterus. There was a good push.
That was a good push.
We gotta pull her legs straight back, Logan. Push her back on her belly, but make sure she don't get up. There.
Okay. Still back. Hold on.
We're getting there. Okay, stay there, Logan.
That's better.
Now we got a chance. Oh, yeah. Much better. All right, now we'll put our stitch across there. The gravity is actually holding the uterus. This is just our secondary means of keeping it in. This is a steroid called dexamethasone. This will help with all the swelling that is going to happen after all the trauma that just happened in the back. We got the uterus in.
Oh, yeah.
I think she definitely needs to get in the barn tonight, so
okay.
We'll see if we can rock her up here.
Come on, girl.
Come on, girl. Come on, it's best for you to get up and walk, sweetie.
Yes, it is.
It's too cold out here. Could you check the temp, honey?
Oh, wow. She's 93 degrees. She's hypothermic as hell. She's by no means out of the woods. We got this storm coming in on us.
She's gonna freeze to death out here. Make you a nest. Make you a nest.
We got this cow's prolapsed uterus back in, but she's not wanting to get up on her own. And she is really losing body heat fast. We've got to get her into this barn or she could freeze to death.
We're gonna warm her up from the inside out. This water is 105 degrees. She's 93. Hopefully we can start building on her temperature here. It's freezing out here. Pull the tubes. We'll see if we can rock her up here.
Come on, try.
Come on, come on, come on, come on. No, 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 go! Come on.
We gotta use the loader to get her into the barn. The storm is bearing down on us. She's 93 degrees, normal is 102. We are in crisis mode right now. Now come at her a little bit. Oh, okay. Good, tip it. Okay, good. Okay, go ahead and tip. Good. They're working on getting the heater. I put two bottles of sugar water.
Okay.
Up on my defrost on high.
That will help increase her body temperature a little more quickly.
We're using any and everything we can that's available to us.
Now let's get that tarp over her, funnel in some heat. There we go. We're going in. I'm gonna take her temp. She's already gained 3 degrees. I'm gonna get the IV ready.
Nope.
Easy, girl.
Nope, 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 nope.
Okay, Aaron, I'm in.
She's got a...
I'm in, babe.
She's breathing funny, honey.
Just having a seizure.
Yep.
She's so pale. I'm gonna take her temp again. She's 92.6. She's going down.
Just don't give up, please.
Okay, Stace. Her heart's still beating, she's still breathing. I still think we should push that calcium in her. She's so cold still. From what her color looks like, it's so pale, I worry that her uterine artery possibly did break, you know, before we got the uterus in. And I feel like she may be bleeding out. I know your cows are so important to you. I'm sorry. Oh, I know. She's gone, Stace.
Oh, Mama. It's devastating when we can't save an animal. You know, Stacy is very attached to every one of these cows, but I just want to wave my magic wand and have this all better for these folks.
Okay, little guy. Yesterday was tough, but today is a new day,
and there's other animals that need us. So we're gonna start working on our little screech owl.
Let's do his meds first.
He looks great today. He has his eyes a little bit more open. He's more active and alert.
Boy, he looks better, doesn't he?
All right, and a little bit of food.
Oh, there we go.
There you go, buddy.
What a cute little owl.
I want this little owl to go back to the wild. I want him to go live a life of hunting and doing his thing. I just hope that our treatment today is gonna continue to get him on the right path. Seems like it's working so far.
Let's put him back.
Okay.
But I'm gonna go get a hold of Jeff Jones, the wildlife conservation officer.
Yep.
And we'll see what our next plan of attack needs to be with this little guy.
You have to go to raptor retraining school.
Yes.
Oh, look at our wild animal. Hi, White Nose.
Today we're going to do a surgery to relieve the hematoma that White Nose got because he was scratching so hard because of his ear mites. This is really severe as far as cats go, and we're gonna take care of this today, make it more comfortable. Just gonna basically drape him in here. I'll make a small incision here on the inside of his ear to let all the bloody discharge escape. Okay, are we ready? Ew. I'll make a small incision here on the inside of his ear to let all the bloody discharge escape. Ew. Yum. Today we're doing surgery on White Nose's ear to relieve a hematoma that he got from scratching too hard because of his ear mites. So this hematoma is huge because it's his whole ear. You know, some of them, like on dogs, we'll see little pockets here and there.
Yeah.
It's like he's unvelcroed the front and the back of his whole ear. But, ooh, there's more. He's got a lot of fibrin already in there,
little protein strands.
So that's about as skinny as I'm gonna be able to make that ear, we'll see.
He's not gonna have a normal ear, but
he'll be able to hear. Put the ear back together. Ta-da! Well, White Nose is under anesthesia. I'm gonna try and debulk this ear mite infestation.
That's gross. There's some more.
These ear mites were pretty gross, but after today, he'll be in good shape to go home with his friends.
Ew, look at that. This is why this poor kitty was scratching so bad.
Hey, guys.
Hey.
Aww. Here's your funny kitty.
Look at his ear.
You want to give him a pat? He's still waking up. He's a little sleepy. He's purring. So everything went great with his ear surgery. He actually has kind of a hole in the middle of his ear on this side, and then a whole bunch of stitches on the inside that are tacking it down.
Oh, I think he's getting a little anxious. I think we might put him in his carrier.
Since the Lutes have treated all of their kitties with mite medication, and we've treated White Nose here, he's ready to go home, and everybody should be on the path to recovery.
Thanks, Erin.
High five. High five. Thank you so much.
Let's take him home.
Hi, I'm here to see about the screech owl. Is Ben around?
Is that Jeff I heard?
Yep.
Hi, Jeff.
Hey, Ben, how are you doing?
Good, thanks for
coming. How's our little guy doing?
Pretty darn good. Jeff is our local wildlife conservation officer right here in Hardington. He's gonna take our little screech owl to Raptor Recovery. It's down by Omaha. And they're gonna continue to treat him and try to get him back to the wild.
He looks healthy, looks good.
He's been steadily improving.
Good.
But he's sure not there yet.
Right.
Yeah, but he sort of still has a little bit of a tilt.
Tilt.
Yep. When he first came in, we were really worried that he might have a little bit of a detached retina in the back of his eye. I know they're gonna reevaluate him there, but looks like we still have a little bit of blood or hyphema in the back of the eye. You know, it's a little bit hazy.
I know they deal with detached retinas regularly down there on birds that we bring into them, either hawks, owls.
If that retina is detached and he cannot go back out to the wild, then what happens to him?
He will be an educational bird. They will take him into schools, summer camps.
Yeah, that gives me goosebumps.
It feels pretty good to get this little owl back on his feet, literally. He's starting to straighten up and open his eyes again. Now that was a cool case.
Boom, baby.
Good.
I'm gonna be sad to see little bugger go. I was kind of getting attached.
So one of our clients, Kathy, just gave us a call.
Hi, guys.
Yeah, it's so good to see you.
Same here.
She's got a down sheep that had babies a couple days ago and has been running a fever and not doing well. Oh, look at her. I see the problem.
She's trying, but she can't quite get up.
When your animals are not feeling well, it's just makes you just feel bad.
What do you hear, honey?
She's a little bit raspy.
Mm-hmm.
She's got a fever, 103.5.
On a recent mother, the first place for an infection we really need to look is the uterus and a uterine infection. Okay, 1, 2, 3.
I'm doing okay, it's okay.
Nothing abnormal, nothing yucky, icky. That's good.
Watch it, push that back leg in.
Just not quite there, is she?
Nope.
The normal places where she should have an infection really aren't checking out.
We need to draw blood and then maybe give her some IV, just some sugar and some things to get her going.
Yeah, we'll get a fever reducer on board too.
Let's get this done. I feel like we got to move on this sheep here. I'm getting really nervous because this sheep is really starting to pant. We need to get this IV going, get some medicine on board here, or this could go very south here very fast.
No.
Hey. Oh, dang it.
We lost the IV. I'm actually hitting her vein really easily, but then when she's looking for her babies or struggling because she's nervous, she's jerking her head around and it's pulling out the IV.
Okay. Oh, it's okay.
Nope.
Hold on. Oh, it's okay.
Nope.
Hold on.
We've got a mama sheep who's in trouble.
We're out.
This is not going quite according to plan. She doesn't understand that we are here to help her. She needs to get this IV in her.
It's okay, Gabber.
We're in.
Oh, excellent.
She seems much more relaxed. I think the medications and the fluids and everything are helping. So, Kathy, the IV is all finished.
Okay, good.
We're going to take home the blood and the poo and take a look at those. And then we'll give Kathy a call and see what Gabby does over the next 12 hours. I'm about to run Gabby's blood to see if there's anything to give us any information as to why she is not getting up. So we basically have low protein and low red blood cells. Everything in Gabby's blood work is pointing at a heavy parasite load. It's gonna be imperative that we get that fecal run and get the results ASAP.
Poop soup. The sheep are not big animals, and so they can't handle a lot of parasites. They are usually stomach worms, and stomach worms are pretty deadly if left untreated, and they can spread from sheep to sheep really, really quickly. Check this out. Oh,
poor Gabby.
I am finding a lot of eggs. Yep, this is why we're laying around.
They're just taking all her energy, feeding themselves.
Yeah.
Either she's gonna die or she's obviously not gonna be able to feed these babies anymore.
I need to call Kathy. We gotta get a dewormer in Gabby's stat. Hi, Kathy. It's Ben Schrader down at Cedar County Vet.
Hi, Ben. Good to hear from you.
Unfortunately, I have a ton of stomach worms on my slide. Do you deworm very often?
I do, usually spring and fall, and I use the standard brand name each time.
Maybe there is something to that. We've been hearing of resistance to some of these dewormers, if we use them multiple times. All we have to do is change up the dewormer on that worm, and we'll be able to get it killed. I'll get it ready for you. It'll be waiting here on the counter when you come, okay?
Thank you.
These are here.
A few days ago, we delivered a litter of 9 adorable corgi puppies via emergency C-section.
Hi!
Hi!
And since the births were a little traumatic, they're in today just to make sure everyone is progressing normally. So today, we'll check everybody's weight so we kind of get a nice baseline, and then you can take those home. You can sort of weigh them once a week, kind of keep an eye that everybody's moving forward. So brown girl, 8.5 ounces.
I know, I'm gonna make you so mad. Your face looks fine.
What are you calling her?
Blue.
8.5 ounces. These puppies all look fantastic. They're like little fur jelly beans. Light boy, 10 ounces.
Oh my goodness.
Anytime I save an animal, I always form a special bond with them. That is especially true of the one puppy that almost didn't make it, Sassy.
I can't believe you hung in there, little girl.
Oh my gosh, she is sucking the daylights out of my fingers.
I know.
9 ounces, Sassy. I don't see any reason today that she is any different than any of these puppies. She actually weighs a little more than the first two, so she obviously is doing all right.
You're not even the runt.
I wasn't afraid she was going to be the runt.
I know, she is not. She's feisty. You know, a case like Sassy, this really shows that you just never give up, and you don't win every time. But the one time you do out of 100, it's worth doing it. Call if you have questions.
Okay, I will. Thank you.
Yep. Last call, and then dinner.
Friday night, 5 o'clock. Ooh. That's how we do it.
Being a vet in a small town means you're on call 24/7.
You can't get mad. You just have to roll with the punches, take care of the animals the best you can, and live every day like it's something to really live for.
Terry has a calf that is pooping straight blood.
Probably another coccidiosis.
I would say that's my guess. Coccidiosis is a protozoal parasite that calves get either by ingesting poo that's on their mom's udder or drinking contaminated feces out of puddles. We've already lost one cow this week, so I'm really hoping we can save this little calf.
Yeah, he was standing up about a half hour ago.
So this is a very typical coccidiosis calf. Up 1 hour, down the next, they lose that blood so fast.
Look at all that blood.
This calf has got a cold mouth. He needs to go into your shop.
Okay, I got a place in the shed up there we can take him.
We knew this calf was pooping blood. I didn't expect him to be as cold as he is. This is a big deal. If we don't intervene right now, we're gonna lose this calf. Okay, I'll hold him, you tip it up. Aaron, make sure we put on our gloves when we work on him, because you know this is possibly a zoonotic disease too.
Sweetheart.
Coccidiosis, it's a bad bug. It really takes these bigger, strong calves down really fast.
No play.
We just got to get going on this calf and try to get it saved.
Ooh. Hang in there, buddy.
How cold is he?
93.7.
Wow, that's cold. He's very hypothermic. When you're in the low 90s and you're supposed to be about 100 to 102, that's a big problem.
His ability to kind of regulate his temperature is going away. And so I'm gonna try and fix that first. Does your wife have a cruddy old electric blanket?
Yeah, there might be one in the house.
We don't get this calf warmed up. He's gonna die like now.
Terry's calf is suffering from coccidiosis. He's lost a lot of blood and he's hypothermic. We need to pull out all the stops to get him treated quickly.
Terry's out looking for an electric blanket. I also have the fluids up against my chest to try and help keep them warm.
Here's our bicarb.
Bicarb will help with his respiratory rate. It'll help him stabilize.
This used to be on my bed.
I turn her all the way up.
That's gonna give us a chance. I'm gonna blow dry this fluid line. Well, I'm blow drying the line here so that we're actually getting warmed fluids going into this guy.
We're already gaining. We've come up 2 degrees, but it's now 94, but we're shooting for 100. Wow, I think we're winning.
We're winning with this temperature.
Yeah, look at that, it's a 99.8. So it's working.
There we go. That heart rate is about a million times better.
What the? Look at those numbers. They're just jumping up perfect. Temperature, 100 degrees. Unreal. Yep. Look at that. He's winning.
Especially after losing Mama Cow earlier this week, it feels amazing to have Terry's calf come back from the brink of death right in our arms. Something really positive and amazing happened today.
Coccidiosis is a terrible disease, and we have to prepare ourselves to treat the whole herd so that we don't have any more of these.
I hated to bother you all the time.
We're meant to be bothered.
Yeah.
That's the vet's life, you know?
Yeah. Yeah, one of these days we're just gonna come over and have a nice cold beer with you, though. A few days ago, Kathy came by and picked up a dewormer for Gabby and the rest of her sheep. So we're gonna swing by her place and make sure mom and the babies are doing great. Hey, Kathy.
Hey, guys.
Kathy, where's she at here? Everybody's standing.
Is that her?
That is her.
Oh my goodness, she's standing.
And her babies are butting against her. She keeps her balance.
That's a different sheep.
Friday night, when I came to feed, she was standing up just by herself. And then from that point forward, she's more attentive to her babies. She's a miracle.
Yeah.
Oh.
Well, that's great. I'm glad you dewormed all the mamas in here, because if one has some worms, you know they all have some.
They're all going to.
What we should probably do is take some feces from a few of the different mamas and see how we did with that first dewormer.
Okay.
Because you don't want to over deworm them either.
Oh,
that creates resistance in the worms.
Okay.
If we just kind of periodically use it when we need it, then we'll have the dewormers that'll last us for many, many years.
That's the goal.
It's pretty cool when we can go from a down sheep to one that's up and raising her babies, and it's just a good thing.
Couldn't have done it without you.
I'm proud of Gabby. That was really, you know, way to rock it out, Gabs. The Gabster. Gabalicious.
Stop. Hi, Terry.
Hey, Doc.
Got your good help with you today?
Yeah, good help.
Who's this guy?
Cody.
Nice to meet you, Cody. After last night's close call with the calf, we want to make sure we treat Terry's 80-headed cows before he has a crisis on his hands.
Hi, buddy.
Terry, I see this calf is a little bigger and stronger than the rest, but that doesn't matter. Coccidiosis doesn't care. And I want to show you on this calf how you can go ahead and treat everybody, all right?
Okay.
Awesome. You know what? Let's just take his temperature quick. Okay, Aaron, right behind you. I don't want to take your temperature.
I didn't sign up for that today.
103.3. So that's a little bit above normal. 102.5 is about the top end of normal, but it's a hot day.
Yeah.
I'm going to squirt this medication right in his mouth. Okay, Terry, hold him up here and squirt it down. Make sure he swallows. Okay, he swallowed right there, and we're done. There he goes. He's treated.
Do you want to give him the bad news, or should I?
So we gotta medicate the whole darn herd for 5 days.
Okay.
Unfortunately, that's what we got to do to break this life cycle.
Okay.
That's why he got you here. You didn't know, really, but come help Grandpa turned into treat every calf for 5 days.
I can't say that Aaron and I have ever given up on any animal.
You just never give up.
And that's the motto we always live by. And it's not always taking the easy path. Help Grandpa a lot, all right?
Yep. Make sure and get a lot of ice cream out of this deal.
Yeah, we have it for breakfast in the morning.
You and I both have to put our heads on a pillow every night and feel in our hearts and in our soul and in our mind we have done the absolute best for the patients and the people that we help. Nobody does this alone.